Hello guys, welcome to today's session. We're at the lovely Berry Hill fishery. Aim of the game today is to try and catch some bream, possibly some tench. The weather's a bit windy, so the conditions are a bit against us, but hopefully we can put some nice fish together in the net. Okay, so the ground bait for today's session, we're going to go with the ever faithful Thatcher's Original and F1 Dark. Going to mix this pretty much 50-50 today. Going to be looking at catching some big bream, possibly some tench. So we're going to go for 2 pints of Thatcher's. 1, which is pretty much a whole bag, to be honest. 2, and then same again of F1 Dark. What I will do is one of the F1's Dark, I just run for a sieve just to remove some of the bigger bits. Let's do that quickly. Although it's warming up and the fish are starting to eat now, still just want to take a little bit of that feed content out. There we go. Get rid of that. And then one more pint in there. Then what I do is I add 2 pints of water. Just gives you a good starting point for your mix. When you come back to that, we'll be there or thereabouts. Don't worry, it's gonna look a bit sloppy and horrible, but after about half an hour, 40 minutes, that is gonna be bang on. And that is today's ground bait. Okay, so the gear for today. It's a bit windy, so we've only got 13 meters of pole out. We're gonna fish a number 6 slip, perfect skimmer and bream elastic. Then we've got 1 gram Kerry float tied to 013 power line, down to an 010 fluorocarbon hook length and a 16 SFL. The consistency of the rig's really simple. It's a bulk of number 8s with 2 number 9 droppers. The other rig we've got set up is exactly the same, except it's a 0.75 Kerry, and the shotting pattern's slightly different on that one. We've got like a tapered spread out bulk on that one. So we've just fed our ground bait today, fed 2 lines, 1 line straight out in front that's quite a positive line to be honest, fed 3 sensible balls of ground bait with dead maggots, micros and a few worms minced up finely. fed the ground bait quite wet, but not really squeezed the balls too hard. Then we fed another line round to the right, fed it a bit more negatively, just a few dead maggots and two smaller balls of ground bait. We're not too sure how it's going to fish, so we've sort of covered both options, and hopefully you see us fishing the nice positive one, catching some big bream. Okay, so we're an hour and 20 minutes into the session now, and literally had our first bite probably 25 minutes ago. Started on the negative line, and to be honest, we knew it was going to be slow to start. The fish are not normally in on the pole line straight away here, so just sort of sat there and waited and waited, and eventually got a couple of bites. We have hooked a big fish on this line, probably a carp that just sort of decided to swim off, and that was the end of that. But just going to sort of stick on this negative line for now. We've topped up with one little ball of ground bait after the carp, and we have caught a fish since. So hopefully we can just keep odd fish coming along on this line, and then hopefully in another half an hour or so we can have a look on that positive line and see if we can really put some fish in the net then. Okay, so there we go. Come today fishing for bream. We lost a big fish early on that we suspected was a carp. And 10, 15 minutes later, we've gone and nailed this one. So definitely a few carp about today. Just goes to show, balanced tackle, get your gear right, you can land pretty much anything. Right, so we're 2.5 hours into the session now, and the fishing's been pretty good, to be honest. Obviously, we started on that negative line, caught some fish early on and lost a carp. We went onto the positive line. We did catch three and lost one quite quickly on that. So obviously, we topped that up with little wet balls, sort of golf-sized ball with some more minced worms and maggots in. Then we dropped back in on the negative line, and we did actually manage to land a double figure carp. So the carp are proving to be a bit of a nuisance today. But I think if we keep topping up, keep plugging away, we're going to catch some more bream and make a nice day of it. So we topped up that negative line and gone back on it and actually hooked another carp. This one, same as the first one, he just sort of swam off and said goodbye to us. So we're going to up the game a little bit. We're going to take the six slip elastics off. We're going to put some 9 Dura slips on, step up the hook length size. and feed a bit more positively and see if we can put some carp in the net today. But in saying that, we've still got the positive bream line out in front. So hopefully we can still put a nice net of bream together as well. But it'd be nice just to land some of these carp rather than them just seeing us off. So the positive line, we've caught some fish on it, just sort of playing around really. And the last feed, we didn't feed any worms. And this time is the first time we've dropped in and not had a bite on it. So we're gonna feed some more worms and see if we can draw some more fish back into the peg by putting a few more worms in. Hopefully we get a nice response from this. One other thing to say is we've had to swap the rigs around a little bit. We've changed from the 0.75 gram Kerry over to the 1 gram Kerry. Obviously the wind's been really bad here today, and we're just starting to get a bit of a tow and the wind pulling your rig around a bit. So putting on the bigger 1 gram Kerry float has made a bit of a difference. Helps us keep the bait on the bottom a bit better and sort of keeps it nailed over the bait. Everything seems to be bang on the bait today rather than in and around it. So definitely just feeding those little golf balls, keeping your hook bait as on top of it as possible has definitely given us some more bites today. Gonna ship back out on the negative line. Although I can't really call it the negative line anymore. It's had quite a bit of bait. Obviously, we keep hooking carp there and they're hungry. So you've got to keep feeding them. Right, that's the end of the session for today, guys. It's been a really nice, enjoyable day. Been nice to be able to feed some bait. Obviously, it's coming to the end of February and fish is just starting to look for a bit of bait. So it's been nice to be able to feed some bait. Best line today has been the positive line that we fished straight out in front. The negative line round to the right was good for a while, but then the carp moved in and they've sort of messed it up a little bit. Probably ended up feeding a bit too much bait on that line, but simply because the carp kept moving in and out, you know, they tend to push the skimmers out, caused us a bit of aggro on that line. But topping up on this positive line, golf size ball of ground bait with minced worms and dead maggots, and dropping the 1 gram Kerry rig right in on top of it seemed to be the best way to get some bites. As the winds died towards the end, probably could have changed back to the 0.75 Kerry. Might have just got us and have a couple more bites towards the end there. But must say a big thank you to Old Berry Hill Lakes. They've allowed us to use keep nets and bits and pieces that you're not normally allowed to do here. So keep an eye out for the next videos, guys, and don't forget to like and subscribe to the YouTube channel.